evening. This is Left, Right and Center. I'm Nidhi Razdan. Tonight, this morning as he landed in Chennai from London, Karti Chidambaram, the son of former Finance Minister P Chidambaram, was arrested by the CBI for not cooperating in a corruption probe against him. The CBI has accused Karti Chidambaram of taking bribes to help a big media company get illegal clearances for foreign investment by the Finance Ministry when his father was the minister back in 2007. It's a charge Karti Chidambaram has strongly denied. Is this corruption as the CBI says, or is this vendetta as the Congress claims? That's the big focus on the show this evening. Also tonight, the other big political story, the Congress is on its way to winning crucial by-elections in Madhya Pradesh. And for the BJD, there's a huge win in Orissa today. First Rajasthan, now this. Is there a bigger political message in these by-polls? The Congress's man of the moment, Jyotiraditya Sindhya, will be joining us later on tonight. But first, the big story today is the arrest of Karti Chidambaram. The CBI says that he took bribes back in 2007 from INX Media, then owned by Peter and Indrani Mukherjee, for using his influence with his father, who was finance minister. He used that influence, the CBI says, to get an illegal foreign investment clearance for INX Media. Karti says the allegations are rubbish and politically motivated. The trial court today gave the CBI 1 day remand of Karti. The CBI, though, wanted 15 days.
Karti Chidambaram shouting out in defiance against his arrest at the Patiala House Court in the capital. He was arrested as soon as he landed at the Chennai airport this morning from London for using his father's influence to help a media company in exchange for bribes for up to 5 crore rupees. Just days before, his chartered accountant had also been arrested by the Enforcement Directorate.
Well, the CBI took Karti to Delhi. Taking a flight to Delhi just later was his mother Nalini Chidambaram, while his father P Chidambaram was away in London. Well, they've always maintained this to be a false case. Today, they refused to react.
The CBI says they arrested Karti months after they registered the FIR in the INX Media case because they have fresh evidence of a larger bribe, which could be up to 5 crore rupees. In fact, this fresh evidence comes after Indrani Mukherjee, a co-accused in the case, was interrogated by the ED and sources say confirmed paying bribes to the then finance minister's son. They also said that Karti was refusing to cooperate with investigations, not appearing when he was summoned. But Karti denied this, saying that he was not a Hindustan leaver but a Hindustan returner, an obvious reference to Nirav Modi.
In a hearing that went on for over an hour today, the CBI demanded 15 days of custody of Karti Chidambaram, saying that he had not cooperated with them so far. Karti Chidambaram's lawyer, Abhishek Manu Singhvi, however, contradicted the statement, saying that the CBI had no case, no fresh evidence, and that he must be given bail.
No grounds of arrest were furnished. As soon as he landed, he was arrested. No grounds have been furnished till now. It's the last summons in this case from the CBI. Was exactly 6 months ago on 28th of August 2017. He has not been summoned, therefore there is no ground for saying there is non-cooperation.
As soon as the arrest was made, the Congress cried foul, saying that the government was using the CBI to distract from the multi-crore Punjab National Bank scam.
Classic diversionary tactic by Modi government. Congress party will not be deterred by unleashing of vendetta against Mr. P. Chidambaram or his family. We will continue to speak the truth. We will continue to expose Modi government's corruption and we will continue to hold them accountable to people of the country.
When such issues are raised, what is important is that the nature of evidence available against the offender must speak for itself and not the alibi of vendetta.
While some question why the arrest has happened now, when a charge sheet also has not been filed, the CBI says that it cannot reveal all details which are sensitive. However, it is confirmed that Indrani Mukherjee, as co-accused, played a key role in Karti's arrest.
Bureau report, NDTV.
And what Sukirti was saying there in her piece to camera about Indrani Mukherjee, of all people, playing a key role in Karti's arrest, let's talk about that now. Because the CBI claims that it has receipts that prove that payments were made to Karti Chidambaram by Indrani Mukherjee and her husband Peter, and by the way, both of them are currently in jail and they're being tried for the murder of her daughter. That's a separate story. But Indrani Mukherjee's statement to a magistrate says that they met Mr. Chidambaram in his North Block office and then they met Karti at the Hyatt Hotel in Delhi. Sunetra joins us now for more on those important details, because Sunetra, what the CBI is essentially saying is that they have proof, that they have actual proof of receipts which show payments to Karti's companies from Indrani and Peter Mukherjee. Tell us more about that.
Well, what's interesting is that till now we had no evidence at all. They just told us that they had evidence of payments, but that evidence was only for 10 lakh rupees. We didn't have access to it. In court, the CBI said it's too sensitive. We can't talk about it openly. Let me just take you through what we've accessed till now, which they said led to his arrest because they needed to confront him with all these details. First of all, Indrani's statement. Indrani and Peter Mukherjee. Indrani earlier in the year, after December, was in Enforcement Directorate's custody. And what happened there was that she recorded a 164 statement, which is in front of a magistrate, which makes it admissible in court. Now, we can't verify what she says, but basically the 164 statement said that, one, very importantly, till now all we knew was that Mr. P. Chidambaram was finance minister and his son influenced him to change the decision in payment for that money. Now it turns out, according to Indrani Mukherjee's statement, that they went, Peter Mukherjee and Indrani Mukherjee met him in North Block, after which he apparently suggested to them that they should go and meet his son and also help his businesses. This is what the 164 statement says. That's what the highlighted portion also says. They were meant to let Karti Chidambaram, and also the 164 statement said he also said help his business by giving foreign remittances. Karti Chidambaram then is said by Indrani Mukherjee in her 164 statement, said that she made payments up to $700,000. Now, this could be just a statement. What they have also produced as evidence are the receipts of these payments and the invoices, which we'll have up in on your screen as well. It shows a signature by Indrani Mukherjee as a form of payment, and they made to two companies which the CBI and ED say are Karti Chidambaram linked companies, although he denies it. One is Advantage, which has been the one in the case from the beginning. The other one is, of course, to North Star. So here you have 60 lakhs payment. Here you have the bank account details, which is made to a bank agent, Bank of New York, also by Indrani Mukherjee. And you also have the date. So for the first time, you have a money trail. And then you also have the $500,000 payment made by IMX Media to Advantage and to North Star as well. These are the payment receipts. Now it's up to the courts to decide. But basically, this is the evidence which they say they got via the chartered accountant that they arrested 2 weeks ago. And this is what they're going to present in court.
All right, that's pretty important stuff. And let's go straight across now to Abhishek Singhvi, who is Mr. Karti Chidambaram's lawyer and, of course, appeared there in court today. Mr. Singhvi, would you first want to respond to what the CBI is putting out as evidence against Karti, these receipts to these two companies that they say are linked to him, including Advantage? They say there's $700,000 that were paid by Indrani Mukherjee and Peter Mukherjee into these companies, and they have receipts to prove that. Mr. Singhvi.
Nidhi, let me set the terms clear, because it's a one-to-one with you, and as you know, being a counsel in the matter, I am not going to get into any debate, any response, as you put it, any argument. I'm only going to summarize my case with two additional points. The additional points are these. I am quite astounded. I have come as late as 6:30, 7 o'clock from the court. The CBI, we were waiting from 2 to 4:30. They produced a person after 4:30. So it went to a duty magistrate and he heard us, then he had to deliver judgment. Now the first astonishing point, Nidhi, is that none of what you are saying about this statement, this recording, this payment, this 164, not a word of it was argued in court by the CBI public prosecutor. I've just come from the afternoon. I wish that this habit of releasing to channels and not saying in court was now put a stop to by this government. Second, so therefore, you know, I'm taken aback. The only argument was a two-page remand application in writing, which said
A, he is a flight risk. We apprehend he is travelling abroad, he will run away. Second, that he is not cooperating. And third, one bare sentence, tampering with evidence. On those three points, I am only summarizing my submissions. I am not arguing, I am not giving an appeal against the order. I said it is a bizarre case because there are, the last time he was called, which alone is evidence of non-cooperation, is 28th August 2017. For 6 months, he has not been called by CBI. So how can you arrest him for non-cooperation? Because the basis of non-cooperation is a summons to him. You haven't called him for 6 months. The second thing on flight risk is the very bizarre thing again, because here is a man who travelled abroad under Supreme Court and High Court orders for 10 days each twice. He came back on time, he gave his flight details, he gave all details, and as I said jokingly, he's not a Hindustan leaver but a Hindustan returner, and this is the reward he gets. The third is tampering with evidence, not a word anywhere. Now I come to the points you made for the first time on TV today, obviously because the CBI trusts the media more and before than it trusts the court. Because today we've had a hearing, they've not revealed any of this in the oral arguments. They've shown some file and they said they are sensitive information, said nothing more. Now, on this charge which they told you on television, please appreciate, as far as one name you took, it was in the other matter also, the same advantage is the one which is alleged to have got a bribe of 10 lakhs. Now the amount is changed only. But the beauty is that Karti Chidambaram, I repeat, has never been, is not any shareholder or director at any point of time ever of advantage. Ever.
He has no link to it whatsoever. He has absolutely no link to advantage whatsoever.
I am repeating, forget link. He is not a shareholder, not a director, no link, no connection, nothing. He has said so 10 times, I am repeating it, I said so in court today in respect to 10 lakhs. By the way, the 10 lakhs, the funny part is that TDS deducted check payment. Now, coming to your next point. This thing about this statement, you know, it's easy to fool people, but if you as a layman pick up section 25 and 26 of the Evidence Act, it says that a person in custody, as Indrani and Peter Mukherjee are, for 2 years on murder charges, their statements in recorded during custody are inadmissible. He's already in custody. You can extract any statement during custody. Therefore, section 25 and 26 of the Evidence Act was created that you do not admit statements recorded of people in custody. Now, the 164 of the statement is a new thing absolutely. We have not heard of it in the arguments. As and when they are put tomorrow before the court, we will point out this law. And in any case, now I come to the last point, Nidhi. Today we are not discussing innocence or conviction or guilt. The question we are asking is, why arrest? What is the need of arrest? The man has spent roughly 36 hours on the two times you called him with the CBI, another 36 hours on the two times the ED called him.
I take that he's point. And you're right.
If you give a first summons, he will answer.
No, one more point.
If you want to confront with Indrani,
yeah,
the law is very clear. You can confront him by summoning him. Please call Indrani to the office tomorrow. Confront him. Why do you need arrest for that? We are not discussing guilt and trial and conviction, we are discussing arrest.
But let me ask you, Abhishek Singhvi, is there a real danger though that this is a case that could also engulf his father, P. Chidambaram as well, because the accusation is very serious. This allegation that the CBI is leaking about these receipts is very serious. And if it is proved to be correct, it could, it could really be something that could ensnare Mr. Chidambaram as well. He was the finance minister. Was he unduly influenced?
First of all, everything I have told you has been argued by me in court. It's only a summary of my arguments, save and except the point about the statement which was never put in court. Number two, I am not in my political role here with you, as you know. I am not going to speculate because I am a counsel. None of this insinuation and innuendo that they have a receipt about Mr. Chidambaram, a recorder about Mr. Chidambaram, about Hyatt Hotel, about North Block, has ever come in front of us. It is not in the remand application. As and when it is stated or raised, we will of course fully meet it. Because a statement, as I said, by Indrani Mukherjee, at the end of the day, it's a statement by an accused of a murder charge for 2 years, recorded during custody. During custody, a statement recorded is inadmissible. What's the point of taking a person in jail to a 164 magistrate? He or she has already been in jail. So we'll deal with all that. But the point is, very unfair to raise it with the media in the night when the whole day you're in the court arguing it.
Alright, well, let's see how the arguments in court play out. Abhishek Singhvi, thanks for joining us, the lawyer for Karti Chidambaram, there arguing and telling us what the basic defense is, also saying that on this issue of these receipts that are allegedly linked to companies allegedly linked to Karti Chidambaram, that this is something that was not argued by the CBI in court. J.V. Shergill of the Congress with us tonight, Mr. Shashadri Chari, who is of course an analyst and senior leader of the BJP, Mr. Amrinder Sharan, senior advocate of the Supreme Court, and Shahid Siddiqui is our commentator here tonight. Mr. Shashadri Chari, to you first. You would have heard what Abhishek Singhvi was saying just now. It is an interesting point, though, that he made, that if the CBI does have these damning papers against Karti Chidambaram and these receipts, as they say that they do, why not raise it in court today? Actually, they might have had a better case for remand then.
No, you know, Abhishek Manu Singhvi is representing Karti Chidambaram. So, I don't think he would be the best advisor for the CBI as to how CBI should conduct the case. As far as these papers and leakages and other things are concerned, I mean, he is directly accusing all the channels, including NDTV and also the CBI, for leaking these papers. If NDTV has been able to do some investigative journalism and get some papers, I don't think Abhishek Manu Singhvi should be pointing it out in this kind of a left-handed compliment as far as NDTV is concerned. And the third and the most important thing is, what he says is that Karti Chidambaram was not a director of Advantage Strategic Consulting Services, whereas the, as per the records of the company, he was the director till from 2006 to 2011. It was only in 2011 that CBN Reddy, Padma Vishwanathan, Ravi Vishwanathan and Balakumaran or somebody was made four directors. And then there are other incriminating documents that these four people who were made directors of Advantage Strategic Consulting Services, the first thing they did after taking over as director was write a will. And in the will they have categorically pledged all the shares of Advantage Strategic Consulting Services to Karthik's daughter.
But these are all reports. So
these are all evidences.
But where is this
over
evidence?
And above these evidences.
Because I've read those reports as well, which you are citing, and I know who's written them as well. But is, I mean, that doesn't seem to be.
These evidences are available. What the CBI has said is they have received new evidences, and the new evidences are very categorical. Not only that, there is an evidence as far as the beneficiary is concerned, Advantage Strategic Consulting Private Limited, and they have even given the account number of the beneficiary.
So let me ask the Congress party there.
And can read out.
Abhishek Singhvi says, that Karti Chidambaram has nothing to do with Advantage. Okay, I'm asking the Congress this, Mr. Chari here.
But it is for the court to decide.
Yeah, Mr. Chari is saying he was a director in 2011. Was there any previous link that's not being revealed?
Nidhi, transaction is of 2007. The government has been in power for the past 4 years, point one. Second, please, for your viewers, to establish the need to arrest a person, you have to establish that he will flee the country and tamper the evidence. We've been hearing the BJP. Can please BJP explain why the law of this country is different from Karti and different for Nirav Modi, different for Abhishek Singh, Jay Shah and Choksi? Is Karti Chidambaram being arrested because he doesn't give donations to BJP? Is Karti being arrested because PM doesn't call him Mehul Bhai openly? Let Mr. Shashadri say in open court, 16 February 2018, Madras High Court passes the order, evaluates whether he'll flee, whether he'll temper evidence. The court in its own wisdom allows him to go abroad, asks him that you come back and report wherever you waited. Is this crime that he returned to India? If the CBI could not convince the High Court that Karti will flee and not cooperate, how come the Supreme Court and the High Court allowed him to go? Didn't Karti deserve a chance of summoning from the CBI and to be confronted with this evidence? So today the larger message is, friends of BJP can loot and scoot, whereas law-abiding citizens who will come back to the country under the supervision of the court will be arrested. The point is, was his arrest necessitated or warranted? The point is, now why have you arrested Karti today? Again, Mr. Chari, you have listed. Are you the judge, jury, executor? Is the trial completed? Are the witnesses being examined? What warrants his overnight stay? Are you going to beat him and ask what Indrani said? Why couldn't Adani be called tomorrow? Now, you have a condition here. Who will investigate? How did Nirav Modi escape? I have a letter to the Prime Minister, 26 July 2017, asking you, Mr. Prime Minister, don't let him escape, otherwise it will be Malia Part 2. Why is the CBI not investigating who helped all these people?
But what about JV? I'm asking you what I asked Abhishek Singhvi as well. This time it seems to have gone beyond just the CBI doing these arbitrary leaks. They seem to be now suggesting that there is a paper trail, and that makes it much more serious.
Nidhi, you know, I'm not his lawyer, and I argue on a dimmer. Please presume they have the best evidence today. Arrest of Karti Chidambaram is not made on the grounds, on the strength and the weaknesses of your evidence. As a lawyer, arrest is again repeating made whether he will flee or temper. There is enough evidence today that people in the government helped Nirav Modi. Why is nobody arrested? Why is Mehul Choksi nobody arrested in the government? Why nobody arrested to let Malia escape?
Okay, I'm going to talk about the larger political message that is playing out here, but I want to ask Mr. Sharan on this point of law that, you know, it is interesting that the CBI didn't argue about these receipts in court today. So are they saving this up for a better day? A different day? What could be the logic for that?
I think whatever strategy they are following. But then the arrest is not justified. Because under section 41A, if the person is to be, the maximum sentence for the offences for which he is likely to be arrested is less than 7 years, then four conditions must be met. He is likely to repeat the offence. He is likely to flee. He is likely to tamper with the evidence. Or he is likely to affect the course of investigation. But none of these is present.
So you feel it was an over-the-top reaction?
I think the arrest at this moment was not justified. After all, the case is lodged since so many years ago. The offences took place in 2007. The paper trail is already there. He is not interfering. He has no powers to interfere now in this. When you have already collected the evidence, then what is the need for arrest? Pre-trial detention. The other thing, the statement made under section 164, it is not evidence. It is only a statement of an accused or any person who makes the statement.
Abhishek
the evidence
Singhvi
will be
says,
after he is...
No, but Abhishek Singhvi says that can't be admissible in court. Is that correct or can it be?
I think there is some error there, because admission made or a statement made in a police custody is not admissible. But she is not in police custody. She is in judicial custody. So it will be admissible. In evidence, if she goes and gives evidence, she will have to be cross-examined, and then it's a statement by a co-accused.
So ultimately the key, I think, will depend on the CBI being able to establish proof that these companies that they're claiming were paid off by Indrani Mukherjee were actually have links to Karti Chidambaram.
In the trial.
In the final trial.
But so far as the arrest is concerned.
You feel that that arrest was not justified.
That arrest is
However,
justified.
Shahid Siddiqui, let's talk about the political question here. So you have this really bad news that's hitting the government day after day on the Nirav Modi scam, right? And then you have this arrest that comes. You also have now also a spate of arrests that have been happening in the last few days of people who've defaulted on their bank loans. So there seems to be a message that the government is trying to send out that we are serious about cracking down on corruption and we're not going to spare anybody, even Chidambaram's son, and possibly even Chidambaram.
Definitely, the trial will decide of his innocence or not. It will take some time, but the arrest is very much political. I can see that the arrest is political. Arrest was not required, as the legal luminaries are also arguing. It has been made to send a message that, look, it's not only us who are responsible for corruption today. Congress is much more responsible. The message is that the Congress is responsible not only for Nirav Modi, not for only for every other crime which has been committed in last 10-15 years, but here is a direct involvement of the former finance minister, because the effort is to somehow bring in the name of Mr. Chidambaram, or even directly involve him, or even if required arrest him and send a stronger political message and diversion. So this is a diversionary tactics, no doubt, and anything to do
but
with politicians, anything to do with politicians.
But if the evidence is strong, then yes, even if it's a diversionary, if the merit of the case is strong, then
absolutely,
it has to be pursued.
Absolutely. I agree with you that it may have a lot of merit, but the way it is being, executed,
politics is very much in it. You see, any politician, if he is involved rightly or wrongly in a crime, then politics come in from both sides. Politics is, will come in from Congress, politics will come in from BJP. You can't avoid politics. Politics will be there and it will be read into the whole situation.
Let me ask Mr. Chari about the questions being raised on the timing. Mr. Chari, what the opposition seems to be alleging, and some commentators and others seem to be saying, is that this has happened now because the government is facing the heat on the Nirav Modi issue and really wants to stick its neck out and say, no, we are serious on corruption. Also, I mean, it is a little odd that the last time the CBI summoned Karti Chidambaram was 6 months ago, and now they're talking about him being non-cooperative in the investigation, and he did turn up 6 months ago. They didn't call him in between. So why was he arrested now?
See, I'm not holding any brief as far as CBI is concerned, but I think when an argument is made that look, the High Court allowed him to go and he went and then he gave all the flight details and everything, it's not a great obligation that he has done on the state of government. It is a statutory requirement and it is a judicial requirement that he has followed. The High Court specifically said that you should inform the High Court and the government about all the details of your travel. That is exactly what he has done. So when he came back, CBI has enough proof to say three things. One, he was tampering with evidence. Two, he has been giving informations which are not very correct. To tell you, I mean, in other words, he has given wrong information and misleading information to CBI. And CBI has got enough proof to say that not only that he has lied before the CBI, but he has also tampered with evidence. And CBI is equipped to prove all these things. And therefore, we have to watch and wait and see. And the court has not given CBI 15 days. Although CBI wanted 15 days judicial detention, they have given only 1 day. So the CBI will have to argue it out in a proper manner.
But what about the timing, Mr. Chari? Coming in the middle of this whole Nirav Modi mess, what about the timing?
The question is not Nirav Modi. Tomorrow there can be other cases also. So many other cases will come back. But the question is, if this arrest has been made, there is enough proof in the hands of CBI and they have got certain papers which will go further to nail the case. Therefore, we will have to wait and see how the court takes it, what court decision court takes. But to pronounce that he is not in concern with this company, that he has not done anything wrong and therefore the arrest is political, he is crying vendetta, and this is not going to help the Congress. Tomorrow when the proof of the pudding is in getting it proved that he is innocent, which he is not. There are enough evidences, and even going by the small bits and pieces that have been received now, even in these informations, the amount is not small. The amount of companies that are involved are not
except
small.
Except that I'm just wondering that why the CBI didn't come out with this 3 or 4 months ago, 5 months ago, a year
it's
ago.
It's not a question of when. As and when the CBI comes across, we do not know what more evidence will come. These are only some of the small evidences. In 2017, when the chartered accountant of this company was raided, there were 14 officers.
Well, there were documents
raided.
Seized from his hard disk. But you know, Javi,
the point about timing is still being investigated.
The point about timing becomes limited after a while because it's like I asked Shahid, that if they have concrete paper trails, if there's merit in this case, then it has to proceed. It doesn't matter what the timing is.
Please, with all the might of the law, please. But Nidhi, tomorrow, God forbids, you and me are involved in something, in a crime, and law applies differently to Javir and differently to Nidhi. Can we trust the administration in the system? No. The point I am trying to make is CBI behaves like a hawk when it comes to opposition and a sleeping sheep when it comes to the government. The point is Mr. Seshadri Chari has donned all the legal knowledge, being a super lawyer. Where are these arguments to explain how the government has slept over three great escapes looting the public money? How there is a pattern. When we were cornering them on land acquisition, Veer Bhadr Singh's daughter was raided on the day of her wedding. On the other hand, Vyapam, Mr. Shivraj is crowned.
You have a pattern where Congress leaders are booked, jailed, harassed. And you have another pattern where the Neera Modi's party is Malaya and Lalit Modi are treated as specialized guests. Ms. Sushma Swaraj makes a call to London for his travel arrangement. The point today, the nation is asking, why is the law and the system will work differently for opposition and the government? If yes, then whether it's timing today or 10 years down the line, yes, we will raise
Mr.
a
question.
And let me tell you one thing. Today, Ms. Chari, you have done us a favor. From today onwards, you have strengthened Congress' resolve to expose Prime Minister and his brigade about their involvement in Modi, Mehul Choksi and his entire brigade. The clock starts from today.
Well, I'm going to ask you a little bit more about that in a second. Yes, Mr. Chari, quick response. Yes.
You know, it's very easy to compare all these things, but let us not forget one thing. All these people, Nirav Modi is linked to the Congress. And he started with when there was UPA government.
And he flourished under the
again,
NDA.
Here again.
Who's Abhishek Singh?
Here again, it was during the UPA government.
Who's Abhishek Singh? Isn't his name in Panama with his house address for the past 4 years?
Have
you
sent
a notice to him?
That
Vijay
Group. It was during UPA government.
No, I know you have come to brief of Karti, but explain it to me. Who's Abhishek Singh?
Was purchased by
Why the government not send him a notice for the past 4 years?
Purchased by company. And the owner of DIGO company who purchased Vijay Mallya's UB group writes a letter to Mr. P Chidambaram and his son Karti Chidambaram thanking him. And not only that,
so you're saying all of them are linked to the Congress. But unfortunately, they all seem to flee under the NDA. And in Nirav Modi's case, they also flourished.
So when the heat is on all these people, they flee the country.
Okay.
They flee the country.
But they shouldn't be fleeing under a strong government's watch.
It's not the question of fleeing under the strong government or a weak government. That the fact that they were caught red-handed and we had proof against them, they fled.
He can't appear before them. He's from the CBI today only.
Mr. Chari, operation successful, patient dead.
One second.
That's your argument.
Amrinder Sharan, how much would you
trust? There is no guarantee that Karti Chidambaram would not have done the same thing had it not been for CBI to oppose.
I think you missed the news in the morning for your Congress. He came back.
CBI argued
to enlighten you. He came back from London.
He should not be allowed to leave the country.
Sir,
okay,
sorry,
well,
he came
look,
back from London.
None
he
of us are here. Let the courts pronounce his guilt or innocence. But would you, as a lawyer, would you trust the credibility of Indrani Mukherjee's statement? I mean, the woman is in jail for murder, for God's sake.
She's a co-accused.
Yeah.
A statement of a co-accused against another accused. What the
this really needs to be corroborated much, much more.
Much, much more. And it will have absolutely zero evidentiary value. If it is inculpatory, she's inculpating herself, then she will have to get pardon from the court, then only it will become admissible. If she is exculpatory, then it is not admissible at all.
What does that mean?
This means if she is involving herself in the crime and confessing that she has committed a crime, then it will become admissible only if court grants her pardon.
Oh.
And if it is not inculpatory, it is exculpatory, in the sense that she says,
she's accusing
I am not guilty,
someone else.
Only he is guilty, then it is not admissible at all.
Well, in this case, if she's paid a bribe, as she's seeming to suggest she has, I mean, it would obviously implicate her. But Shahid Siddiqui, the last point is to you. Politically, this is very important because it's very clear that as we head into the next general election, corruption, the Congress, the Gandhi family, that clearly is Mr. Modi's focus.
Absolutely.
That he's reminding people why they voted the Congress out in 2014.
Absolutely.
And to give him another chance.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And that's what they seem to be working on, because I don't know whether he may have committed some crimes. Maybe Mr. Chidambaram was also involved, Karthik was involved. But the point is, there was no need to arrest. Arrest means that you want to make it political, and that is the political message for 2019. The message you are trying to give is that Congress is the fountainhead of all corruption in the country, and we have only been trapped because of that. So because election, you know, Mr. Modi understands that 2019 election will be on corruption, and especially what has happened in his 4 years, 5 years with Nirav Modi and others who have been able to run away, and that's where he's preparing for.
Well, lots to talk about in this case tomorrow, as well as Karti Chidambaram will be produced in court once again tomorrow. Will the CBI get a longer remand? We'll have to wait and see, but the political fallout of this continues. Possibly Mr. Chidambaram, who was abroad, will be heading back to India as well. Let's see if he says anything. Thank you to all of you for joining us tonight.